car, truck, SUV of last year. Fox 5 auto expert Nick Miles shows us his top picks.
Well, right now I am driving the car of the year. But before we reveal what the car of the year is, let's take a look at what the truck and crossover of the year is for this last year. Our choice of the truck of the year was made out of several really good contenders.
When it comes to new 2020 trucks, the landscape becomes very crowded with new offerings. Ram Trucks took the competition by surprise this year with all new heavy-duty trucks. GMC and Chevrolet also updated their heavy-duty trucks, and these will tow up to 35,500 pounds. The midsize truck market changed in the last year with a reintroduction of the Ford Ranger. But the winner of our truck of the year is the Jeep Gladiator, and it has lived up to its promise. The midsize option is all truck and all Jeep, and maybe the most versatile and fun pickup ever made.
Let's take a look at the SUV crossover of the year and some of the vehicles that made the shortlist.
The SUV of the year is a very tight race. Lincoln has a new Corsair and Aviator. Both have Lincoln's signature quiet flight, use phone as a key, and are worthy of an American luxury title. There is a new Ford Explorer and new Ford Escape, both outstanding. BMW have a new X6 and X7. Hyundai has a luxurious Palisade midsize SUV with seating for up to 8 passengers and upscale looks. Mercedes has 4 new SUVs that are eligible for SUV of the Year award, including the GLB that enters a new family space for the luxury German car maker. Honorable mention should be made to the outstanding new Subaru Outback that has a huge center console screen. The big winner this year is Kia. The Telluride is off the charts and our SUV of the year. Starting in the low $30,000 range, fully loaded, it's almost impossible to break the $50,000 mark, which is the starting price for many midsize SUVs. It has outstanding design, tech, and better than many interiors.
We're just moments away from naming what the car of the year is, but before we do that, let's take a look at some of the contenders.
One of my personal favorites was the Toyota Supra. What an amazing ride and one of the most fun to drive cars from the last year. I was the first journalist to do a burnout in the car at the media launch, and millions of Supra fans watched it online. But the car of the year this year is the Hyundai Sonata. So why did it win? Because of the ride quality, the price, the design, and most of all, it wins because of tech. Smart Park Assist, where you can be outside the car and drive it via the key fob. A well-deserved winner of my car of the year. With the car, truck, and SUV of the year, for Fox 5 Morning News, I'm Nick.